this is a second type of micrometer that we are supposed to use. This is known as inside micrometer. Inside micrometer, as we have seen during lecture, it have the arrangement of barrel tube, thimble and ratchet, which is in the same way that of outside micrometer. Only there is a difference of jaws. Here, instead of jaws, the jaws are provided so that they can be used for measurement of internal dimensions. So they have projections like this, and small pin-shaped structure is provided at the top, so we can use it for measurement of inside dimension. Only thing is that in case of inside and depth micrometer, the scales are exactly opposite to that of outside micrometer. For example, if you just see here, this is the first range of inside micrometer, which starts with 5 to 30. Still, if you look at this, the span is of 25 only. That is 5 to 30, the gap is 25. So it starts with 30 and it ends at 5. Actually, it should start from this side. So 5, which is my first reading, 10, 15, 20, 25 and 30. Similarly, the circular scale here, if you do observe, this is 0. And if I start in this direction, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is not 5, but it is actually 45. So here the graduations are provided in other direction that of outside micrometer, means they will start in from this side, that is in anti-clockwise side, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Likewise, they will complete up to 50. When we rotate this inside micrometer in clockwise direction, just see here, the jaws will expand. The jaws will expand. That means initially when it is at 0, like it is at 5 now, because the first reading is 5. So let us say this is the first reading. When I rotate the thimble now, the thimble will start covering the reading. So when you are reading also, you have to read it in opposite way to that of outside micrometer. Means outside micrometer, visible is my reading. In case of inside micrometer, the division which is not visible will be my reading. In case of outside micrometer, the division which was matching or which is below that baseline was the reading. In case of inside micrometer, the division which is matching or which is above the baseline is my reading. So I will just show you how to read this. So let us start reading this. Initially it will be at this position. I am supposed to read this internal diameter of the component. So the reading of this micrometer will start with 5, because the reading over these two pins will be 5 mm. That's why minimum we can start with 5. So distance over these two pins will be 5, and I can start with 5. So initially you have to rotate it in clockwise direction. It will go inside this. Again, just slightly rotate it so that it touches the component correctly. Then lock it and take it outside. And then you can start reading this particular micrometer. So to read this, you have to just observe the scales. I will just lock it firmly. So from this side, if I observe, the division number 20 is here. This division is not 21, it is 19, 18, 17, and this is 16.5. so division which has been covered by this thimble is 16. So my main scale reading is 16 mm, and division which is above this is 20, this is 19, and this is 18, and this is 17. So division above this baseline is 17. So 17 is my circular scale reading. So for better understanding, I have drawn the sketch of this particular reading on a page. We have measured this internal diameter by using these two jaws. So as I mentioned, the graduations are provided exactly opposite to that of outside micrometer. So 30 is here. In this way, the graduation will go on decreasing. Actually, the graduation starts from this side. So 5 onwards this. So when we rotate the thimble in clockwise direction, the thimble will start covering this reading. So you have to read that reading which has been covered. So the reading which has been covered is actually not visible to you. For example, in this particular case, this is 20, 19, 18, 17, and this will be 16.5. So 16.5 is visible to me. That means division number 16 has been covered. So that's why main scale reading is 16 mm. To read circular scale, again circular scale is graduated in opposite way. So you have to either find out a match between baseline and circular scale reading, or you have to read that reading which is above the baseline. So for example, here the reading which is above is division number 17. So 17 multiplied by not 1 is the least count, 0.17 is the reading. So 16.17 mm is the final reading of this inside micrometer.